Is it possible to build a game console having such a set of elements? Yes, it is. And what a console!
Hello, the latest domestic and international news. Electronic devices continue to become more and more expensive. The prices of computers and consoles have increased by 10% in the last month alone, and retro devices by as much as 15%. Inflation also affects other areas of everyday life. Coal costs 12% more today than a month ago. We are calling the Prime Minister to ask what the government plans to do about the galloping inflation. Compatriots, you must take matters into your own hands. You need to start building the game consoles by yourselves.
Hi, nice to see you on this channel. What do we have here? A microprocessor with a socket. This chip belongs to the MCS51 family, which means it is a relative of the Intel 8051 microcontroller. A few buttons and a switch. Several buttons and switch overlays. Dot matrix LED displays. 3 digits 8 segment LED display. Some discrete components, capacitors, transistor and resistor. Piezoelectric buzzer and USB socket. PCB and battery case. Time to turn on the soldering iron. Let's try to make something out of it. This video is definitely not a soldering guide, especially because I don't solder very often. Nor is it a complete detailed course on how to make a simple game console. Please treat it rather as a curiosity and a short reportage. The more so that I'm not an electronics engineer, but only a modest IT engineer. Ha! Of course, the presented console is not my project, but a ready-made set for self-assembly both on the internet. So let's get to work! When installing electrolytic capacitors, it is necessary to pay attention to their polarity. Some good flux certainly facilitates soldering. It is worth remembering even when using tin with rosin. The IC socket has a notch on one side. It must be properly inserted as marked on the circuit board. The more so that its desoldering in case of an error is not easy. When installing transistors, it is worth paying attention to the pin's description. The shape of the transistor case is usually drawn on the printed circuit board, and you need to match the transistor to this drawing. Piezoelectric buzzer has plus and minus as well. dot matrix LED displays also require proper assembly, especially since it's hard to desolder them later. This 3 digits LED display also needs to be mounted properly. Just a quick wash and the console is almost ready. Inserting a chip into the socket is not so easy if you do not have a suitable simple device for bending the legs of integrated circuits. Unfortunately, I do not have. Of course, such a chip must also be properly mounted so that the U-shaped notch on the socket corresponds with the notch of the integrated circuit. Let's turn off the lights so that you can see the displays better. Time for the first turn on, and success! Works right away. The casing still needs to be mounted quickly. I didn't show its elements at the beginning of the video. Let's assume that they are in bonus. Wow, what a surprise! The console has 4 games. It also allows you to set the brightness level and to turn the sound on and off. Even though it seems very simple, it is actually quite pleasant to play. We have Tetris, known for years. We can also play the famous snake. There is also the simple racing. Finally, there is the Raiden game. Do you know how exactly this console works and why it is designed this way? At the end, let's take a quick look at the schematic diagram. The design is incredibly simple. We have the previously mentioned microprocessor from the MCS51 family, to which three displays are directly connected. The first one with three digits, each with seven segments, plus an additional dot next to each digit, not used here. We have 10 used pins of this display connected to the microprocessor. 3 are used to select the currently displayed digit. 7 indicates which segments building a given digits are displayed. The 3 digits number is therefore not displayed continuously, but alternately at the beginning the first digit, then the second, next the third, and again the cycle starts from the beginning. We call this multiplex display. The digits flash so fast that it is hardly noticeable. This gives the visual impression that all digits are lit simultaneously. Ideally, this speed should be even faster and then this effect would not be noticeable at all. It is also worth adding that it looks better when looking at the device with the naked eye than on a video recording. In addition, we have two dot matrix displays. Each has LED diodes placed in 8 rows and 8 columns, so in total it needs 16 control lines. However, to control two such displays by a microprocessor, not 32 lines, but only 24 lines are needed, because 8 lines are shared by both displays. Here, as before, the whole image is not displayed at once, but line by line. High speed makes the image appear solid. Plus, we have several buttons to control the operation of the device. Here, each button is connected directly to the microprocessor line. Finally, a piezoelectric buzzer with its own generator connected by means of a resistor and a transistor, which here serves as a kind of switch that activates the sound based on the signal from the microprocessor pin. It is certainly not a dream console, and it is far from the latest devices. But how much satisfaction in building it? Stay healthy!